Hello and welcome to part four of creating sports graphics with Boris Continuum. With me, Ben Brownlee from Boris Effects. So we have now got our first textures on our model. What we're going to do in this part of the exercise is actually continue on that and add some more decorative elements to bring a bit more depth and a bit more life to the model itself. So we're going to be doing this both in Title Studio and also creating some of the elements in Illustrator as well. So let's come in and add some decorative touches. All right, so here is where we have it so far, back in After Effects. And yeah, what I want to do now is just add some decoration onto the outer ring here. This is a sort of technique that I use a lot, just to kind of add in some extra contrast and interest to the scene, because it can get, you know, if things are a little bit flat, a little bit dull, you know, that's not what we're going for. Okay, so let's pop back in to Illustrator, shall we? I'm just going to open up the circles that we started on earlier, the ones, the coloured circles here. So we have our outer ring, which is this one. And I'm not going to do anything too clever with this. What I'm just going to do is add some text over the top here. And to do this, I'm going to create a new ellipse. Let's actually make a new layer as well. And I will call this one decoration. Let's come into the center. Just click and hold. I'm going to hold down Alt and I'm going to hold down Shift as well so that we can transform this from the center. And I'm going to bring this around about here-ish. There we go. Cool. And let's pop into our type tool. And I'm going to do type on a path. There we go. Let's turn the other one off. And I've got my lorem ipsum going all the way around the path. And I want to find a suitable symbol to put this in. So I'm going to open up Character Map in Windows. And there's an equivalent for Mac as well, which is the Mac Character Map. I believe it is Command Option T. And that lets you look through some of the symbols there, some of the more interesting symbols we've got. I'm going to have a look in Wingdings. Because you know, wingdings and webdings, it's always good to find some straightforward characters here. And let's have a little look. Not star, let's use that one there. Cool, and we'll just select and copy. And I'll pop back into Illustrator. Have my text selected. Control or Command A just to select all. And then I'm going to paste. And paste. I'm just going to use Control or Command V to paste that in a few times. It's very difficult to see it. So I'm going to select all again. And I'm going to go to my properties. And let's change the character here to Wingdings. There we go. It knows what's up. And let's change the font up as well. 72. Yeah, that's looking good. Right. Let's copy a few more of those in. Control or Command C. Paste. There we go. All right. Let's select all of these one more time. And I'm just going to change the leading in just until it hits there and we get that little crossover turnover there. Yeah, that should be all right. So let's save this out. Save as, and we'll call this one Circles Decoration. Get rid of all of the other layers. Save as. Save it into my EPS folder as an EPS. Circles Decoration. Save. Illustrator 8. Okay. Cool. And because we've made sure that this is the same size as the ring that we've already got, when we come back into Title Studio, this is going to really help us out. So let's do that. I'm in After Effects. Let's come in to Title Studio. Let's launch that UI one more time. And I'm going to take my outer ring and I'm going to duplicate it. So duplicate track. And I'm going to rename it just by hitting on the return key with it selected. And I'm going to call this one Outer Ring Decoration. And just change the EPS file to Circles Decoration. Okay, so where is it? Well, let's take a little look. Let's turn off all the other things here and see if we can actually find it. And we can't see it. And there's a good reason why we can't see it. Pop back into Illustrator and we'll see that reason. In Illustrator, it looks like everything is cool. But let me tell you something, everything is not cool. All right, so let's have that selected. Our layer selector, which we have here. I'm just going to come to type and go create outlines. Because otherwise, if we don't create the outlines, it's just going to come in as text and Title Studio doesn't know what to do with those. So now let's also take this opportunity to turn them white. There we go. And we'll just save that one more time. Circles Decoration EPS. Back into Title Studio. Reload those files. Oh, look at that. It's popped in. It's looking pretty hideous, but it's popped in. And the reason it's looking weird is just simply because we've got all this bevel and extraction, the bevel depth and the contraction there as well. Okay, so let's have a look now. We still can't see it. And the reason for that is obviously because it's stuck in the middle of the regular outer ring. So if I try and sort of come in here and I bring this out a little bit, hang on a sec, let's take that to minus. Everything's very sensitive here. I'm using shift and down arrow to move through a bit faster. And you can start to see if we get to, where is it? Around about 150. Start to see it poking out a bit there. Obviously the material is different as well, so let's take the material value down to 1. Let's not do brush metals, let's do, where were we at? Crystal textures, yeah, ghost white. There you go, so we get a little bit of consistency going on there. Maybe take the extrusion down. Not minus 0.5, just actually 0.5, that'll do. So that's kind of looking all right, except see what happens as we move around. Yeah, we've got tons of stuff, all kind of just floating about and doing weird and wonderful stuff. And that's because when we copied and or when we duplicated the track, we also duplicated all the keyframes here as well, which is kind of cool. It's sort of what we wanted, but we weren't able to offset those in an easy way. Now I could come in here and change all the keyframes, but if these things start to move differently and interact differently, then we're basically on a hiding to nothing anyway. So here's a better idea. I'm going to come to my first keyframe on the decoration and let's come to position. And all of the ones where we have keyframes, I'm going to set these to none. None, none. And I'm going to, actually let's do that a different way. I'm going to come in onto the timeline first and just delete what we have down here. Come to my first keyframe on the outer ring. I've got my spin here. I'm going to set this to constant, set this to 0. Come to my final keyframe, just check that everything else is the same there. It is. Do the same on this one. The outer ring, like the normal one. Set this to constant, set this position to 0, set my master scale. Actually, master scale at 118 is fine. I'm happy with that because that's constant as well. Set that to constant at 0. And on my outer ring decoration, let's set the master scale of that. Was it 118? Bring that out. Okay, so now I can bring this up a little bit. So this is fitting in the right size or the right style. There we go. So about minus 79. Let's check that from the side angle view. Yeah, that's looking all right. What happens if we go minus 80? yeah, we've got a little bit of leeway going around there. Should be fine. Cool. But now what we want to do is we want to be able to group these, the outer ring and the outer ring decoration, so that we can animate these at the same time. And we can easily do that by coming over to this container. And we can either add a new title container. So this is where we can do things for rolls and crawls and, you know, fun stuff like that. Or as a new 3D container, which is what we actually want. So we have both of our layers selected. New 3D container. I'm going to call this one outer ring container. And now with this container, I can actually animate this up. And everything inside that container is going to move at the same time. So let's do this. Let's spin. Where are we spinning from? Around about here-ish, weren't we? Let's get this so it's out the way a bit more. Go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Have the spin pretty much back down to 0 and move the Z position into place. Actually, I don't want to move the Z position quite yet because I want to move forward 1, 2, 3, 4 more frames. I've done it again, haven't I? I've got that keyframe still selected. Good move, Ben. Good move. Right, let's do that one more time. Let's have the spin quite high. Where were you? Around about there will do. Good. Okay, make sure no keyframes are selected here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Go back a little bit. Change my spin down. Around about there, 1, 2, 3, 4, back again. Take the position down to 0. And let's see which way the other ones were rotating. So the middle one is moving clockwise, so we want this one to be moving anti-clockwise. Around about there-ish. Yeah, cool. That'll do. And because we got those both as a container, we can do whatever we want to the container and everything else inside it is going to just move in unison. So it's a great way of setting up multiple elements and then animating those around as a single object. The other nice thing about containers is, again, we can get these image processors, these shaders, and we can just apply them to only one particular thing in a container. Or if I bring that over the top, it will apply it to everything, whether it's in the container or not. Let's look at that on the right. There we go. Looking nice, looking warpy. Cool. I'm liking how that's coming together now. Let's hit apply on that. Check that out. Let's do a quick RAM preview. Cool. And now we have our decorative elements on top. Now, of course, because with those decorative elements are an extra object, we can actually go in and just give them a completely different material than we have any of the other ones. So we can get some really nice kind of fine details on those. We do something small and subtle or something quite large. It's completely up to you. So in this exercise, we looked at how we can use text to create a very simple decorative element by coming into Illustrator, finding the right symbol, adding that in, and then converting that text into outlines before we brought it back into Title Studio. We also then saw how we can start to animate up different objects together by putting them into a nice big container. And what that means is we are almost halfway through this project. In part 5, we are going to be adding in 3D models and seeing how easy it is to work with external 3D models directly within Title Studio and some of the stuff we can do with 3D assets without having to go in and re-render or ask someone else to actually work on those assets to try and fix them for us. So we can see what type of stuff we can do directly without anyone else's assistance. And then we're going to be getting into the fun stuff of actually lighting this scene in a more interesting way. So getting rid of the default lighting and doing something a bit more interesting with it. But that's all coming up in part 5 of creating sports graphics with Boris Continuum. So join me there. Thanks for watching, and be sure to go to borisfx.com to download a free trial of Boris Continuum so you can try this out yourselves. If you want to see more of this type of tutorial or you have some ideas of your own, be sure to leave a comment below. Also, subscribe to the Boris YouTube channel to stay up to date with the latest information and training materials on all the Boris FX products.